So it is this experience, waking state experience is exactly similar to the dream state experience. Okay? Exactly similar. There's no difference. While experiencing, it's real. But when you come out of the experience, it's unreal. But can you come out of this unreal experience?
Not
kill you, brother.
To wake up,
dream to waking up is easier. Waking up to the next stage is more.
Okay. So waking up from this dream is called Sahaja Samadhi. Okay. That Sahaja Samadhi practice you'll do today. Right? So waking up from this waking dream is called Sahaja Samadhi. Okay? What is required to wake up from the waking dream?
Withdrawing of all sense organs.
Sense organs shut down. Right? And mind should be free from thoughts. Mind free from thoughts and withdrawal from sense organs is required to realize that the waking world is also unreal. Are you clear? But you, nature itself has given to you. From dream you wake up in the morning and in deep sleep the waking world disappears. Where is the world in the waking dream state, deep sleep state? The world is not in deep sleep state, isn't it? So then still you call world as real? You tell me how all this theory is fine. Tell me how to make my wife or husband vanish. That's why I've come here. The world is unreal or real, doesn't matter. So that will not happen.
It is asatya.
It's asatya. So the dream is experientially real, but factually unreal. Then what was there in the dream? Was there a dream tiger? Was there a dream mountain? What was there in the dream?
Projection of mind.
Mind was there.
The mind means thoughts. Only thoughts appeared as tigers. Thoughts appeared as a mountain in the dream. Okay? Is it clear? So now what are you experiencing? Only thoughts. So, you have to understand to unreality of the world, you have to understand unreality of thoughts. If you understand unreality of thoughts, you understand unreality of the world. Okay? So, unreality of the thoughts is prakriya for the next class. Today, unreality of the world is the prakriya. Is it clear? If the thoughts are unreal, the world is unreal. So, Sri Shankaracharya gives a teaching, Brahma, Satya, Jagat, Mithya. Okay? Brahman is real, world is unreal. Brahma, Satya, Jagat, Mithya. Okay. So Jagat means the world what we see, world which is available to our experiences. It is like a snake. When I say Brahman, what is this Brahman?
Consciousness.
I.
Atma.
Whatever you call, now in our future classes, we do not use the word called Atma, Brahman and all. Okay. Just use the word called I. The Sanskrit word for Brahman is called Aham, which is called I. Because the more words we start using, we'll get confused. So I alone is real. Okay? I alone is real. And the world is unreal. means perception. Okay. So when I say I, there are two aspects of I. When I wake up in the morning, I feel I am there. Okay. In deep sleep, I am there, but I don't know I am there. Okay. So there are two aspects of I, is I am and I call it as pure consciousness. I call it as manifest consciousness or chidabhasa or reflected consciousness. They are all same. I am and I. Are you clear? I am is manifest consciousness and I is pure consciousness. Where is your I am? Where is it I am?
Inside.
Show me inside where?
Means all over the
okay,
body.
We'll find out where is this I am, okay? Hold your hand like this. Throughout your body there is consciousness, no? Right? Throughout your body is consciousness. Oh no, I feel the pain. Pain is the thought. Okay? Thought is there because there is a consciousness. Oh, I feel the pain. Thought has come and gone. But consciousness is there throughout the body. Okay? That is called I am. Okay? This I am is called manifest consciousness or Shiva or reflected consciousness or Chidabhasa. They all mean same thing.
Jivatma.
Okay?
This aham is called for I am or I am?
I'll take next. I'll take.
Can you repeat that?
Yeah. So, Brahma Satya, the word Brahman alone is real. Now, what is Brahman? Then again, we start getting some chakkar. Because it's a Sanskrit word, then we'll start imagining some things. Where is Brahman? All around. So the simple definition of Brahman is I. Okay? I am is Brahman. Now when I say I am, it's the consciousness which is there throughout my body. It's called Shiva. If Shiva is there, if Shiva is not there, you become Shava. Body becomes dead. The manifest consciousness is there, that's called Shiva. When I say Shivaham, I am already consciousness. I don't have to become Shiva. Are you clear? Yes or no? Maitri. So what is the difference between thought and consciousness? Very simple to understand. Pain is their thought. Oh, pain is not that this thought. But consciousness is not changed. Are you clear? Is it clear?
So thought is something on coming on the consciousness.
Thought is appearing and disappearing with
on the consciousness.
Uh-huh. But consciousness itself is the background.
It's constant, yeah.
It's constant. And that's called God, Shiva. Now you tell me, are you the thought or are you the consciousness?
Consciousness.
If you are a thought, the person in coma is to be burnt. Person in coma is not burnt because he has no thoughts. But his consciousness is there. Right?
I is also Brahman, I am is also Brahman.
We'll find out what is the difference between these two Brahmans. Right? Both are Brahman. I is Parabrahma, I am is Saguna Brahma or Ishwara. Okay?
Is not reality an consciousness referring to the same thing?
Yes, they are same.
So technically you don't have four, then you have only one.
What is one?
Reality, Satya, consciousness, Brahman.
Huh.
But all of them are basically referring
to... No, that's actually referring to the same thing. Reality, Satya, / consciousness, / Brahman.
Okay. So reality, we are talking about reality in this class, but we were talking about consciousness till now. So they both are actually the same.
They are same names.
Names for the same thing.
Same thing. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So then there is... So please stop using the word Brahman very often. Instead, use the word called I. Okay, what is the real I? You'll find out. Okay, so wherever Brahman is there, the whole purpose of Vedanta is to teach you wherever Brahman is there, substitute the word called I. Okay, so this is what we learn in Vedanta. Otherwise, we'll keep on learning Brahman, this Brahman, Parabrahman, and all. our mind will be confused with a lot of words. Finally, only one word should remain, I. That is the beauty of Sri Ramana Maharshi. Ramana Maharshi took the entire Vedanta and condensed it to one word called I. Just one word called I we have to use. Whenever I say Brahman, it's ultimately it's I. When I say Parabrahma, it's I. When I say God, it's I. Okay. So now here there are two I's we have to distinguish. I am and I. Right? When do you get the feeling of I am? When you wake up in the morning. When you wake up in the morning, there's a feeling of I amness. And the world appears. Okay? When you go to dream, there's still I am and the dream world is there. When you go to deep sleep, there's no I am.
But I exists.
I exists. Okay? So that I is called pure consciousness or Parabrahma. They all mean same thing. Or Sadashiva. Okay? I am is called Saguna Brahma or manifest consciousness or God. They all mean same thing. Okay?
Sadashiva different from Shiva.
Sadashiva is I. Sadashiva. He doesn't. Shiva also appears from Sadashiva and disappears. Sadashiva, Parameshwara, Parabrahma, they all mean same thing. Only names wise difference, but finally it is referring to I. Okay. Now is I am.
I is all pervading. I am is having bounded.
No. I is all pervading and I am is having a boundary. So now this also we have to understand. First we will understand I am. Now let me ask you, I am is Satya or Mithya?
Mithya.
I am is Mithya. Okay? Because I am appears in the morning, disappears in the
deep sleep.
Right? You know that I am appeared in the morning and disappeared. One who knows that is Satya.
So what is the purpose of taking this birth? Why are we all here?
You have to tell me. You have to tell me. What have, you only took birth and you only created all of us.
I didn't ask for it.
Who didn't ask for it?
Okay, I am didn't ask for it.
I am never asked for it. We'll find out what is this I am guy. Okay, this I am is also Mithya and I only is Satya. But for a waking state, I am appears to be real. Okay, compared to everything else, I am appears to be real. That's why it's relatively Satya. Okay, it is called manifest consciousness or Vekta. I is avyakta. It cannot be manifest. Okay?
So when you say the rope as reality, satya, it is only relative reality.
No. Rope is satya.
But for, not, it is also not satya.
No. Here, rope and snake analogy is given.
Only in that context?
Rope is satya. Okay, so ultimately consciousness is the satya, but rope I can give a consciousness as example. So example is given.
Analogy.
Okay, is it clear? So there is two levels of reality, manifest and unmanifest, and beyond manifestation. So manifest, unmanifest, and beyond manifestation. Manifest is what we are experiencing now. Unmanifest is when we go to deep sleep, it has gone to a subtle state. And awareness or I is beyond manifest and unmanifest. Okay. So, the example which I have given is rope is world. Rope is the world. Snake is the world and rope is I. Without I, the world cannot see. Without I am, the world is not there. Right? This is my world. I don't know what is your world, but this is my world I am seeing. So the world you are seeing because I am is there. Okay? Right? So the world is Mithya, I am is Satya. I am is Mithya, I is Satya. Okay? This I am is called Saguna Brahma.
So for a jnani, only I is
real. Jnani, I is alone real. For Adnani's I is real, but you only don't know.
This world is Saguna Brahma.
The world is Saguna Brahma. The world appeared from I am. Okay? Now, what appeared from I am? That's because of Adnana, you say I am is body. You cut this into the world, the body also is part of the world. It is cut into I am, body and the world by a thought called I am. I am body. It's just a thought.
So I am is also Saguna Brahma.
I am, the world, is Saguna Brahma. Okay? So you cannot separate out I am and the world. But the separate out, the separation is happening because there is a thought coming out of I am body. A cutting is happening.
What is the difference between I am and I am?
No, I am is a consciousness which is appearing, right? Here. Without the thought also consciousness is there. The thought is appearing over and above that. Because of presence of consciousness, thought is appearing.
And that's called I am
thought. No. That's called thoughts. Out of the one thought is I am the body is thought. Okay? So we'll get into thoughts, more detailed thoughts in the next class, because that itself is own class. What is thought? Is this much clear now?
Saguna Brahma is Shiva. So when you say Shiva, if there is no Shiva, it becomes Shava.
Right.
But in Shava also, the consciousness is in unmanifest form.
That is I.
It is unmanifest.
I.
So we don't say it is a consciousness in manifest form.
Yes, that's called I.
Shiva, it is manifest.
Yes. Shiva is Vekta. Shiva is manifest as consciousness. And Shakti is manifest as the world. Okay, I is beyond manifestation and unmanifestation, right? Existence, or it's beyond existence actually. It's all, you can't say the words.
I am is there, that's why thoughts come.
Of course, if you're not there, how thoughts will come?
Yeah, if I am, that part is not there, then no other things at all. So I am is the basic one for the rest of
life. Right.
The connectivity.
Right. That's called, that's called Chidabhasa or manifest consciousness. It's called I am.
Yes, what she said. Shava.
Uh-huh.
World, because I am has gone.
Yeah. I am has gone. But I is there.
I is there.
I is all-pervading and always there.
It's part of the world.
It is everything. It's everything. Okay. But people cannot recognize I as consciousness. Okay, I is existence.
Isness,
existence. Okay, the consciousness part has disappeared because mind has disappeared from the body. Manifest consciousness. Look what next. So, Jivo Brahmaiva, this is the teaching, this is the way of saying of Brahma Satya Jagan Nitya. Brahman alone is real, the world is unreal. Okay? Brahman means consciousness. Consciousness means I. The I has two parts, I, pure I, and I am. Okay? Then, second part of the teaching of Sri Shankaracharya is Jivo Brahmaiva Naparaha. Jiva is no other than Brahman, which means I am Brahman. Okay? So, right now I am thinking that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Okay? So, I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect is again, mithya. It's a perception. Okay. What is perception? Perception is what is available to
experience.
Is body available to your experience? Is mind available to your experience? Is intellect available to your experience? That is called mithya. Then, is I am available to your experience?
Yes.
That's also mithya. Alright? That's also mithya, but for a transactional purpose it has appeared. Is it clear?
I am always appears, I am the body.
The moment I am appears, I am the body thought doesn't come. When you wake up in the morning, first I am feeling comes. But I am the body feeling will come next.
So I am is independent of these three identities.
I am is the basic. Okay, that's also Vidya, but it appears first.
Okay.
Right?
For very fleeting seconds.
Right. Now if you are able to stay in I am for longer time, it's called Sahaja Samadhi.
That is what you experience in meditation.
Yes.
I am.
Yes. You have to stay there.
So beyond this I am is the I.
Right.
So what would that be?
The I cannot be experienced. I cannot, there's nobody who can understand I. So you have to stay in I am, and you have to know that I is the one who knows I am is there. Witness is knowing I am is there. I is the witness.
So I am is thoughtless state.
Okay. We will practice it.
Is it same as existence? Like
feeling existence. When you say I always points to consciousness, and points to existence. Okay, right. So if I ask you a question, do you exist? What is your answer?
Yes.
I exist. So the existence is referred to as am. Are you conscious?
Yes.
That's called I. Consciousness is I, and existence called am. They are not separate. They are only one and the same reality, expression through two words. So, let us understand this perception concept, perception, right? A five blind men are trying to figure out what is an elephant. Okay, one person touches the trunk, another person touches the tail, other person touches the leg. So, each of them have their own explanations. Somebody says it's like a pencil, somebody says like a snake, somebody says like a wall, somebody says like a tree, somebody says like a rope. Okay? So these five blind men are experiencing the elephant, but none of them know the elephant, right? And they interpret the experience into something. Okay. So what we are trying to do right now is we are experiencing the elephant. And what is this elephant?
Brahman.
Elephant is called consciousness or Brahman. Okay, all around everywhere, we are trying to experience it, the pure I. Okay, and we are trying to experience through five sense organs. Ear, eyes, tongue, and all these five sense organs, they are experiencing the I. Okay,
it's beyond it.
And none of them can tell what it is. None of them can tell what it is. Okay. Right? So now when you touch this, actually you are touching Brahman. when you see something, you are seeing Brahman. Okay? When you are hearing Brahman. But your sense organs are limited in nature. They are and the mind is interpreting, mind is giving a name. The interpretation is the name. Okay. Other than the Brahman or consciousness, there's nothing anywhere. So that is experienced through these five sense organs as the world. Okay. So one thing about the sense organs, right? The hearing sense organ can only recognize sound. The eyes can only recognize form. The nose can only recognize
smell.
Can these five guys agree on something anytime? Because each of them can say only one aspect. The ear can say If you ask the ear, what is the world? World is only sound itself. If you ask the eyes, what is the world? World is only form. It only not only says the world is only form. There's no sound in the world also, you say.
It'll ask what is sound.
Sound is not there. Only form is there. If you ask touching, there's no form. There's only touch is there. There's no sound. There's no form, it'll say. The tongue will say only taste is there. The nose will say only smell is there. Can five blind men agree on anything together? So one blind man saying snake, another blind man saying say tree. They cannot agree. Right? Never in our life these five sense organs have agreed on anything. And still we believe that there's something real because there's a mind is interpreting all these five sense organs and it's giving one its own interpretation also. Okay, so what is there? Nobody knows. No sense organs can know. Mind cannot know. Mind is interpreting what sense organs are giving, and sense organs themselves are fighting with each other. They actually don't agree with anybody. One sense organ will never agree with anybody.
The mind is interpreting.
Interpreting.
Also integrating.
Integrating,
I'll say, is interpretation, finally. So it's a tree is there. It's a final interpretation. Integration has happened. The touch, smell and all. Then it says tree.